Turkey's policy towards the Syrian crisis has taken a major shift in recent days, with the Turkish Air Force striking at the Islamic State of Iraq and the Levant, the group known as ISIS, as well as at Kurdish PKK militias. Turkey is now also said to be working with the US to clear a border area that will become a safe zone for Syrian rebels and refugees. With me to discuss the events in Turkey is Daniel Dombey, who has just returned from his posting as Turkey correspondent for the FT. Dan, explain to us first why this shift in policy has taken place. Why now?
We see in this area of Syria, in this border area between Syria and Turkey, a border between NATO on the one hand and ISIS on the other. This was always going to become a conflict zone. But Turkey resisted this for a long time. It had reservations about some of the Kurdish rebels who fought against ISIS. It felt that the real enemy was Bashar al-Assad in Damascus, and that was the core of the problem in Syria. And President
But it was quite complacent in the way that it was dealing with ISIS, and it, although it's part of the coalition, it wasn't striking at ISIS.
Absolutely, absolutely. And so we saw President Recep Tayyip Erdogan really say the Kurds were just as bad as ISIS, make clear that he really didn't want to be involved very actively in this fight against ISIS. But little by little, things changed. First of all, you saw an ISIS strike against Turkey in the very beginning of this year in January, when someone killed herself in the tourist center of Istanbul. And then tragically, last week, a suicide bomber killed 32 Turkish citizens, who were Kurdish but Turkish citizens, in a border town just north of a Syrian Kurdish town of Kobani.
So the Turks have discovered that ISIS is a threat to them domestically as well.
Absolutely. That was the realization that dawned on the Turks. But to be clear, this is a momentous decision by Turkey. What we've seen since the bombing last week is not just Turkish airstrikes against ISIS. It's also talk of fortifying the border. It's also a roundup of militants and suspected terrorists. It's also attacks against other terrorist groups or groups they call terrorists. And finally, there's this agreement with the Americans to work on an ISIS-free zone.
Okay, let's just turn to the second target of this shift in policy. And this is the PKK, the Kurdish militias. Turkey and the PKK have been in a peace process for the past 2 years. Why confuse the picture now and strike at them as well as at ISIS?
I think there were reasons why Turkey was going to act this way. First of all, the people who were killed last week by ISIS were Kurds. The Kurds have maintained for a long time that Turkey, at the very least, did not sufficiently fight ISIS and in some ways turned the blind eye to ISIS. And so the Kurdish militants killed three Turkish policemen in response, they said, to the ISIS killing of those 32 civilians last week. I don't think any state would allow the killing of policemen to go unpunished. And we then saw a whole series of airstrikes against Kurdish positions, which, to be honest, are far greater than the strikes they've done against ISIS.
But is there any domestic element here, domestic political element, because of the results of the last elections?
Absolutely. There's one of the arguments that Mr. Erdogan's critics are making is that his party, the ruling party, failed to win a majority in the last election because there was a very strong vote for a Kurdish party which has been seen by some as the political voice of the PKK, the Kurdish militants. Many of Mr. Erdogan's critics argue that by not trying to stop the escalation of a fight against the Kurds, he's demonizing those Kurds. He's summoning nationalist votes. And in a time when early elections in November are a distinct possibility, in fact, some people say an increasing likelihood, the Kurdish party's hopes are perhaps reduced, the AKP's hopes of a majority are increased, but the great risk is that this particular violent conflict could get worse. And therefore, we have Turkey right now with the risk of an ISIS blowback and already a series of murders by the PKK of Turkish policemen and army officers. It is a very fraught time in Turkey right now.
There is also a lot of talk that Turkey has now convinced the US that there should be a safe zone for Syrian rebels and Syrian refugees within Syrian territory. The US has been very reluctant until now. They seem to be changing their position. Why?
I think there's a quid pro quo here. One of the most important things that the Turks did after this bombing that killed 32 people last week was to open up the airbase, the huge US airbase at Incirlik, and perhaps at least one other airbase, to fly bombing missions against ISIS in Syria. This is something they'd refused to do for months and months and months. Now, there were reasons to do this. It's part of a more active attitude against ISIS. But the other part is there's clearly a quid pro quo, because the US seems to have succeeded to one of Turkey's long-standing demands to open up a safe zone, a virtual no-fly zone, an ISIS-free zone in northwestern Syria. On the one hand, that stops ISIS advances. But on the other hand, what that does is put, the Turks hope, their Sunni Arab allies in those places, rather than the PKK-affiliated Kurdish militants who the Turks really don't want to see there.
Thank you, Dan.